Welcome back, everyone. You know, we are talking now with Solar Sandy, and I tell you something, it is hot out there. Even though there's cloud coverage, it's hot. Everybody's using their air conditioner. Welcome back to the show. Tell everybody, you know, you're on such a mission. We don't really even have to say much about you to introduce you, but go ahead.
You know, Carol, I am, and I'm even on a greater mission this year than I was last year, because this year it is May, and APS raised the rates last year, August 19th, the kilowatt costs. But that was just the first part of the rate increase, and what I really want my families, our families that are listening today, to understand this. There is a warning up on APS's website that is actually, it's very insidious. It says your bills could, you'll see 50% increases on your APS bills due to the weather. No, folks, it's not due to the weather. It's been hot in Phoenix for years and years and years and years and years. The reason you're going to see significant, and I mean significant increases, it could be more than 50%, depending on what rate plan that you get on. And if you didn't choose, APS chose for you, and you are not going to like what they chose. None of these rate plans are good. So let me explain this to you. They are selling you the same power that you bought last year. They're just selling it to you differently. Let me say that again. It's the same power that you had last year. They're selling it to you differently. And if you don't understand the differences on how they're selling you this power, there is a significant increase. And even if you do understand it, you're still, your bills, your $300 bill last year could well be over $600, and a $400 bill last year could well be over $800. And I'm not joking, and I'll tell you why. A Corporation Commission allowed APS to add 4.5% increases to the kilowatts. You think that would be good enough for APS? No, 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 they weren't done yet. They are calling this a rate plan change, and they're changing the names of these rate plans, and they make them very confusing, and they want it to be confusing, because under each of these rate plans there's a cost for the kilowatt. So they sell you the kilowatt and you think it's all said and done, and then they add the fees and the taxes and the surcharges on there, and that's bad enough. But now there's an adjuster, and they sent out a letter the beginning of this year, says pricing shown is for electricity use only, is subject to change, and it does not include any applicable taxes, fees, taxes, or adjusters, or other fees. So they've told everybody that's APS that their bills are going to change, maybe 50% or more. They have not included the fees, taxes, or adjusters in here, Carol. And what the adjuster is, so they sold you the kilowatt, and there's a cost for the kilowatt under all these rate plans. So then they add the fees and the taxes and surcharges. But there's this thing called demand. And it's during 3 to 8 p.m. It's the hottest time of the day when we do most of the living in our homes. And, you know, rightfully so, we've worked hard to go home to a comfortable house and not have to worry about our electric bills being, you know, $8,000, $9,000. So now that kilowatt that was, let's say, 15, 20, 30 cents, whatever it is on whatever rate plans you have, during that time, those kilowatts are going to be even more expensive, because it's the time of day when they have to supply more power. So this is why it's called demand. And I use this analogy. You know, back in the day when we had landlines, the telephone companies told us, call nights and weekends, it's cheaper. And if you call during the day, it's going to be more expensive. The telephone lines were no less cheaper on nights and weekends than they were more expensive during the day. Just the telephone company made more money for the convenience for you calling during the daytime, demand time, than on nights and weekends. So the telephone companies made money daytime, nighttime, weekend. They made money both ways. Same thing with kilowatts. They've sold you the kilowatt once, and now they're going to figure out how many AC units you have, what appliances are running all at the same time, and they're going to measure the highest use of your electricity when you're causing demand to their grid over 60-minute intervals. And they're not going to tell you when those 60-minute intervals are. They're sneaky. And so when you turn on a light, or you turn on your TV, or you turn on the fan and your AC is running, those are surge, and those cost money. So the amount of electricity those appliances cost, so you're running them consecutively over a 60-minute interval. An average home, 2,2500 square foot, could be using 20 to 25 kilowatts over a 60-minute interval. For each of those kilowatts during that demand period, it's $17.44. 10 times $17.44 is $174. 20 times 1744 is $348, $350 on top of your kilowatt cost. You already paid for the kilowatt here. So you've already paid for it here. It's $250. Now you have a $350 charge for your demand on top of that. So a $300 bill just went well over $500. A $400 bill just went over $700-$800. People are not going to understand this, Carol. I have sat and I have studied these rate plans backwards and forwards till my head hurts. I have sat down with board of directors on electric companies. And because one of them lives in the other electric company district, and it's told me a lot of inside information. SRP people, you're going to get hit too. May 1st, your rates went up too. There's demand in SRP. And here's the thing. They need to call me. They need to fill out a kilowatt worksheet, and they need to sit down with me and get a rate plan review and understand these rate plans, because your power cost is going up. PYOP, produce your own power. So I help my families by putting solar panels on the roof. But that's not where it stops here, Carol. Last year it was just solar panels. Now I've got to put a smart energy management system on to manage that demand. I'm kind of outsmarting the power companies on how much demand you're using during this period of time. You're going to be able to live more comfortably, live just as comfortably as you want, actually live more comfortably, cooler.
And you're going to know how much you're going to pay for at least the next 20 years.
Exactly, Carol. And there's no money to get started. There's no money out of pocket. If you own your own home, you have good credit, this is your power bill. It doesn't matter how high yours, mine, whoever doesn't have solar on their house. I have solar on my house. You're having solar on your house. But it doesn't matter how high your power bill goes. People are going to pay their power bill. I don't care how high it goes. People, when it's 125 degrees out, are going to pay their power bill. So if you've heard me before, Carol says this all the time. If you've heard me before, even if you've met with me before.
I have to talk.
Well, you might have to talk in a minute because my knee is really bad today.
So let me say that for you. Yeah, let me say this. If you've heard Solar Sandy before, call her, because let me tell you something. These things change minute by minute, and she learns more information all of the time. She's out there on a mission. I'm going to give her a little water. She's out there on a mission to help everybody out there save money on a bill that you're already paying way too much money on. And by the way, it is May 1st, so you know that your bills just went up because you said that was going to happen, and it's now May 1st.
Carol, APS just changed to their new rates. SRP just went to the summer rates. So everybody who thinks that their bills went down in SRP, they just went back up again. And demand in SRP, May and June is 23 something. And in July and August, it goes to super peak demand. It goes to $34.19. So listen to me, everybody. If you want to continue giving your money to the electric companies, they are happy to take your money. They are making millions, and they will continue to do that. Why don't we rent our cars in the city we live? Why don't we rent our houses in the city we live? Because it wouldn't make financial economic sense, Carol. So why on God's green earth are we continuing to rent our power, so to speak, from the power companies that can raise the rates at will, put them up to whatever they want? And in order for us to live in our houses, we have to pay those bills.
Well, we also know a lot of older people. I'm going to implore anybody that knows anybody that's older. We know it's going to be hot. It's going to be a very hot summer. Let's get them to talk to Solar Sandy and find out how much money that she could save you on a bill. All you have to do is go to her website. It's AskSolarSandy.com. Fill out that kilowatt worksheet. We're going to talk about this further when she gets back. Also, you can give her a call at 623-850-8229. Welcome back. We are talking with Solar Sandy, and yes, she's been on the show a lot. And the reason why she's on a lot is she's on a mission. She's one of the hardest women, working women that I know. And she's out there to help you save money on a bill that you're going to pay no matter what. And you're paying way too much money for it. This is no money out of your pocket, correct?
To get started,
it's no money out of your pocket. And it just makes sense. That's another thing that somebody said. It just makes sense to get an interview with her to talk to her and find out a little bit. It's a consultation about what she can do and how she can save you money. She saved money for my friend, I know for sure, and lots of people. You know, I know you've been out there.
Carol,
I see him popping up all over the place.
Hundreds of people that I've really helped. And, you know, you're going to ask me a question.
And I'm going to do that right now. But wait a minute. What I want to do is tell everybody to go in your website because that's important. I want them to go on that website, and which is AskSolarSandy.com. And you want to make sure you go to AskSolarSandy.com and fill out that kilowatt worksheet now. You're going to get that $200 solar savings incentive as long as you qualify, which most people do. You can also call her. She loves doing consultations with everyone. It's a free, no obligation, free consultation. That number is 623-850-8229. And now I want to ask you what I was going to ask you before. What makes you different than the other people out there that are doing what you do?
You know, Carol, I am just a mom and a grandma and a retired nurse, and I'm not a solar salesperson. I'm not a solar panel salesperson. I am a mom and a grandma who, when my daughter's bill was over $565 and I couldn't help her pay that bill, I really had to look for a solution for her. And, you know, I realized that there was a lot of people that needed help with this information, and it really started me on a mission. You know, from my injuries of my accident, I couldn't go back to nursing. So this, I really feel I am still helping people. We know when I'm very specific. What makes me different, Carol, is when I used to go in to give medication to my patients, I didn't eyeball it and go, oh, I'm going to give you approximately this much medication, you kill somebody that way. And I didn't, by the way. So I bring that same skill set to this, and I have taken a lot of time to understand these rate plans. I know how solar panels work, but, you know, most guys out there do, or a lot of people do. But if you don't know how many solar panels to have and what rate plan to have it with, and with what the demand management combined with that, you are leaving money on your roof, and APS is buying your extra power back for 12.9 cents. My goal is to give my families all the power that they need and extra, a smidge more that we call it, and have my family's bill, APS bill, literally zero or as close to zero as possible. There is a lot of people out there that don't do it like I do. And that's when you hear those bad solar stories like, oh, I still got a bill and my solar panels aren't working. No, no, no. People's solar panels are working. They're producing some kilowatts. But if they still have a bill, what was the sense of them going solar to begin with? So SRP, I can't do that. I'm going to get you buying as little power from SRP as possible. But APS people, if you're not in the queue this year, you're going to leave money on your roof because APS is buying that extra power back, buying it back from you for 12.9 cents. If you're not in the queue and installed by August 31st, and we are almost at crunch time now to get it, you know, signed, people signed up, site surveys done, installation done, and APS PTOing them by August 31st, or they will not get the 12.9 buyback of their extra power. And that's how I zero my APS family's bills out. People, if you want to give $400, $500, $600, $700, $800 to APS, and you're using less power than you did last year, and next year they're going to raise the rates again, and next year they're going to add another fee, tax, or surcharge. This way, you've got all the power you need, a little bit extra, and you are not giving the electric company any more of your hard-earned money. I mean, maybe a little teeny tiny bit the summer when the panels first go on, but after that, your roof is actually paying your power bill, and you know what your power costs from this point out. We all need it, Carol. We all live in Arizona. There is never going to come a day that we are not going to pay our power bills. So I am trying to educate and inform people how to produce their own PYOP. It's not BYOB, bring your own bottle. It's PYOP, produce your own power and pay less for it. And if it's done correctly, And I take great pride in doing this. And if you go to my website, you're going to hear some of my family's testimonies. Robin Q saying, I am very accurate. My numbers and my projections are spot on. That's what makes me different, Carol.
The number to call her is 623-850-8229. The website is AskSolarSandy.com. Fill out the kilowatt worksheet, and she's going to show you how much money she can save you on a bill that you already have to pay no matter what. So you save money on it. And, you know, here's what I say about you, too. Sandy, I think you're incredible. You know,
I think about you,
Sandy, people can't understand. They don't necessarily see you, even though I know we're live on Facebook. And yes, they can see you from there. But they don't realize is the information that you have in your head. That what it is, is that you're the researcher. You literally... Yeah. You study this.
I have, and
all the time.
There is no school to go to for your power bill. Nobody really understands your power bill. And you don't really have to understand your power bill. You just pay your power bill. You have to. So I want to help people understand this. I love saving people money, but I love it when my family's sitting across from me and go, oh, wow, they really get it. And sometimes I know their eyes glaze over and they go, just show me what I'm going to save, Sandy. And I can do that too. But I really have done a very extensive research. I have gone undercover with the electric companies. I have done things that people would probably go, she's cuckoo. But I've done it for my families because I really care about what I'm doing. This helped my daughter tremendously. I have three beautiful grandchildren. She is so ecstatic that she's not paying a $565 power bill anymore. We were just talking about that the other day. She goes, Mom, I'm so proud of you. You helped me, and look at all the people that you've helped. I love what I do, and I love the people I do it for. If the, you know, there's some people out there that may just go, I love the electric company. I want to give them my money. Not going to be offended by that. I am there to help the people who really want to understand. I have a way to help them put more of their hard-earned money in their pocket, Carol.
All right. So most people that are listening, pick up the phone and don't procrastinate. Procrastinate. Don't do it.
Don't procrastinate.
I got upset there for a second. So seriously, because it means that all you're going to do is find out some information, and that's it. And that is a very important thing, because with that information, you'll know what you want to do. But also, here's the thing though. Let's say somebody does procrastinate, and they get chosen a bill. Right. Do they have to stay on it for 3 months, can they call you and say, Solar Sandy, help me get out of this?
Yeah, so I am right now, I've been told so many different things, so much inaccurate information from APS. So my families that are calling APS, I'm telling you, if we work lickety-split together, I can probably get you moved off to the right plan. Because if you didn't choose your plan, APS sent you a letter saying, we chose for you, and this is what you're on. But they need to call me. If they call me before the end of May, they're going to get an home energy efficiency evaluation that's valued at $1,000. What that does is evaluates if they're losing, electricity out of their ducts and their vents. And again, I am not just about slapping solar panels on roofs like a lot of companies out there. I want my families to have the very best system designed to save the maximum savings and the maximum benefits. There's two reasons to do solar: saving money and living more comfortably in your home. And those are the two reasons to do this. And in Arizona, those should be the reason to do this, is that your bills are going up. APS is going up, absolutely, and SRP went up as well. May 1st, you're back on the summer rates. SRP has had demand for longer than APS has. And so I can save people, anybody with an electric bill, pretty much, I can save people.
You can help anyone. That really, we talked about this before. If you're renting a home and you know the owner, talk to them.
Absolutely.
She can help you. If you own the home and you're renting out, please help your renters with this. We know that the summer is upon us. It's already hot. We know that we've already had our airs on. So it's only just going to get worse.
The smart energy management computer that managed the demand, I just had one of my families send me a bill. I am saving them 65% off of their entire bill which does the smart energy management system. This is good for condos, renters, whatever, without the, I can do solar panels on condos, but some condos, some townhouses. But for a renter, they may, maybe the owner doesn't want to help them. Well, they can get a smart energy management. Linda, if you're listening, she's a smart woman. She's like, Sandy, we're only going to be in this house for a year. You can take the smart energy management system with you, because this year, most people are going to migrate to this one particular plan that looks really good. But what they don't know is the demand charges on that is going to be astronomical.
The only way that you're going to know is by giving her a call and talking to her. Let her do a free, no obligation consultation. That number to call is 623-850-8229. Her website is AskSolarSandy.com. Go up there and fill out that kilowatt worksheet and save money on a bill that you're already paying way too much money on.